Good evening, everyone, and welcome to War Child's At Home with the World Gala. I'm Sangita Patel, and I'm truly honored to be hosting again this very important fundraiser. This event is streaming from the traditional territory of many nations, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat peoples. And we trust that wherever this show finds you, the rights of Indigenous peoples are being honored. Although we are not gathered together, that's okay under one roof. I hope that everyone hosting a gala dinner watch party is already having a ton of fun and enjoying themselves with family and friends. Thank you all for joining us for this very special event. This year has been a challenging one for so many, and we are truly grateful that we can come together this evening in support of some of the world's most vulnerable. I want to take a moment to thank our generous sponsors. At Home with the World's visionary sponsor, the Slate Family Foundation, our leadership sponsors, Mantella Corporation, Dentons, and Viking Capital Corporation, and supporting sponsors, TD, Henin, Hutchinson LLP, and McCarthy Hansen and Company. Thank you to our media sponsors, the Globe and Mail, Entertainment Tonight Canada, and Global TV. And a big thanks to everyone who has donated amazing auction items. And don't forget to register at warchild.ca/gala to place your bids and make your donations. And thank you for tuning in tonight to help us raise critical funds for children and families whose lives have been devastated by war, especially those facing a humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan. We'll have the always vibrant Lane the Auctionista with us shortly to help us with that. We've got such a star-studded entertaining evening to look forward to, with performances by Blue Rodeo, Chantal Kreviazuk, JP Saxe, Amaal, LJ Benet, Wali, Shah, and Theo, Tams, plus special guests, Amanda Seyfried, Thomas Sadoski, Troian, Bellisario, and Yasmine, Massri. I'm excited to kick off the show with an actress who really needs no introduction. You've seen her on the big screen in many of your favorite movies. Amanda Seyfried is not only a stellar actor, she's also an incredibly caring individual and a proud War Child Ambassador.
Good evening, everybody. I'm so happy to be here with you tonight to celebrate the wonderful work that War Child does for so many vulnerable children and families around the world. I'm honored to be a War Child Ambassador so that I can help shine a light on the many challenges facing those whose lives are devastated by war and conflict. This has been a tough year for so many people. Life-saving COVID vaccines remain out of reach for so many of the world's most vulnerable populations. The increasing effects of climate change continue to force people from their homes and threaten food security for millions. And many armed groups are seizing on the unrest to cause even more violence and havoc. And 2021 has seen conflict escalating in many parts of the world where War Child works. The fall of the government in Afghanistan to the Taliban has led to a dire humanitarian crisis. Conflict in Ethiopia's Tigray region has forced more than 2 million people from their homes and is threatening to engulf the entire country. And in neighboring Sudan, the military has just taken over from a democratically elected government, plunging that already troubled country into even greater uncertainty. War Child teams are on the ground in each of these areas, responding to these new crises and providing support to those who are hardest hit. And through it all, War Child remains determined to stay, with their local staff working tirelessly to help their communities when they need it most. I'm proud to support this critical work, which is needed now more than ever before. I hope that you will join me tonight by giving generously. Thank you.
Take away this pain. know the black ties and the sad songs I don't wanna sing. And all that you live for on a TV screen. All the places and the footsteps you'll never walk. The good ones always beat the clock. And I don't know where we can go. Ooh, everyone's gotta go home. Some that don't feel the same. Gotta take away this pain. I don't know where we can go. I gotta find the strength. Everybody's gotta go. Yeah. Everybody's gotta go.
Ooh. What a voice. That was actor and singer LJ Benet. Thank you so much for sharing your talent with us tonight. And there is so much more to come. Folks, we need to raise a lot of money tonight for War Child, and that's exactly why I'm here. If you haven't already registered, take a minute right now and go to warchild.ca/gala so that you can bid on all the fabulous auction items, like a rare special limited edition copy of Margaret Atwood's The Testaments. Only 300 copies of the single print collector's item were produced, and each is signed by the best-selling award-winning author herself. There are over 35 bespoke items to bid on, including fashion, beauty, entertainment, music memorabilia, and more. And you know what, kids? You don't want to be left behind on the tarmac, do you? So go ahead and purchase your $100 golden tickets right now for your chance to win 2 Air Canada business class return tickets to anywhere they fly. Yes, anywhere they fly. And the value of this package? A whopping $30,000. That's right, you heard me. $30,000. So here's what I'm going to say. Increase your odds to win by grabbing 2 or 3 or maybe even 20 golden tickets or more, because we only have 500 golden tickets and they are available right now for a little while. And I'll be drawing the winner's name a little bit later in the program. And of course, very, very importantly, please give a generous donation tonight to help us reach our fundraising target of $150,000. As Sangita mentioned earlier, this year has been a difficult one for many. The children and families that War Child serves needs our support now more than ever before. And this is true everywhere that War Child works. And it is especially true for the folks of Afghanistan. To help get the fundraising started, oh yeah, please join War Child ambassadors Chantal Kreviazuk, Thomas Sadoski, Troian Bellisario, and friends for this special message.
What is happening in Afghanistan is a crisis on top of a catastrophe.
After decades of war, suffering, and insecurity, the recent takeover of the country by the Taliban has thrown the future of the country into uncertainty.
Afghanistan is now on the verge of an urgent humanitarian crisis.
More than 750,000 civilians have been forced from their homes by the recent violence.
Children and youth are struggling to access education and other critical services like clean water and healthcare.
And poverty and malnutrition are skyrocketing.
More than 23 million people, including more than 3 million children, face the very real threat of starvation.
Afghan families living in emergency conditions desperately need a lifeline.
And War Child is there for them.
For the last 20 years, War Child has been on the ground in Afghanistan,
providing children and their families with the opportunities to realize a better future for themselves.
When the government fell in Afghanistan, most of the international community left. But War Child is still there.
Our local teams are working around the clock to provide life-saving assistance to children and families who need urgent help now more than ever, but we can't do it alone.
War Child needs your support to keep responding to this unfolding humanitarian crisis. Will you join us?
Will you join us?
Will you join us and donate to War Child today?
Will you join us and donate to War Child today?
We cannot abandon the people of Afghanistan at such a critical time. Please give generously.
Please give generously.
Give generously.
Give generously.
Give generously.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to our ambassadors for that very powerful appeal on behalf of War Child's work in Afghanistan. Tonight I want to tell you why that work is so critically important and why we will stay and deliver despite the difficult circumstances that we are facing. Right now in Afghanistan, as winter approaches, there are many hundreds of thousands of children and their families who are becoming increasingly desperate as a result of the events of the past few months. Many hundreds of thousands have been forced from their homes. They are very vulnerable and exposed, particularly as winter approaches. More than 3 million Afghan children right now are at risk of acute malnutrition as a result of food shortages and economic insecurity. We are there. We are responding to this crisis. Our 100% local staff operate in 9 different districts, and we are providing urgently needed humanitarian assistance for those who desperately need it. There have been a lot of questions over the past few months around what is possible in Afghanistan. We know firsthand that despite the very difficult situation that so many millions of Afghans are now facing, there is still the opportunity for us, for our work, to make a lasting difference, particularly in the lives of women and girls. We want to be there for them. We will be there for them, which is why now is the time for us to double down on our work of the past 20 years to support women and children in Afghanistan, to help them achieve their rights, realize an education, create economic opportunity, and defend them in the face of extraordinary, often extraordinary injustices. We will be there, we will stay, and we will deliver. But we can't do that without every single one of you. So I hope tonight, as you listen to our work and find out more about what it is that we are doing in Afghanistan, I hope that you will support those efforts today, tonight, and into the future. We know that we have a long road ahead of us, but with your support, we also know that we can get there together. With that, I'm going to welcome a figure who should be known to all of you by now, the incredible Lane the Auctionista, to take you through what we hope will be the most exciting and eventful part of our evening. Lane, over to you.
My dear friend Sam, thank you so much. I'm so proud to be here on War Child's most important night of the calendar year. And Sam, I'm speaking to you when I say this. I am promising you that tonight I am going to do everything I possibly can to inspire donations to exceed our fundraising goal. That is my promise to you, Sam. Friends, War Child's work is needed now more than ever. Funds raised will support thousands of war-affected children and their families. Tonight is also an urgent appeal for the people of Afghanistan who are in desperate need of assistance. And of course, you heard earlier on, we have a lofty goal. We must raise $150,000 in donations tonight. You know what? Failure is not an option. And that kind of a goal is going to take a village. It's going to take a community. It is not going to take 4 or 8 people. Well, it could, but I want to make sure that everyone feels a part of this moment. I want to ensure that everyone has an opportunity to give tonight and give what you can tonight. So here's how we're going to do it. Of course, we're using super cool fundraising technology again this year, and that is going to ensure our best possible fundraising result. All you need to do is go to the Donate tab, and there you will find some preset donation amounts. Maybe you want to pick one of those. Or perhaps you have a special number in mind tonight. Perhaps you want to give a very significant donation, and you want to give a very customized amount. Well, we have that option for you as well. So friends, I'm going to tell you something. It doesn't matter that we're not in that ballroom together in person. That is never going to stop us from raising funds, from supporting War Child, and doing what we need to do tonight. So now, I am going to pass the torch to you, our supporters, our donors, and it's up to you to get that fundraising total up and rising. And I'm going to be standing right here. I'm going to be standing shoulder to shoulder with you, side by side, cheering you on, being your biggest cheerleader, and calling out your names and thanking all of you. We thank all of you so much for being here tonight. This is just the beginning of what we're going to accomplish together. So, are you kids locked, loaded, and ready to go? Because I am so ready to go. All right, right now we are sitting at $49,600. Richard Rooney just came in with a $25,000 gift. Richard, I know you are a longtime supporter, the Schneider Family Foundation. Bam! Another $15,000. Maria and Walter Schneider, thank you so much for that. Ken Rosenberg is in at $1,000. This totalizer is bumping already. I cannot believe it. We're at $65,600. I want to say thank you to Sarah Harmer. Thank you so much for a $250 gift. Kristen McLeod, bam, you're in at $150. Peter Stringham, my friend, you are in at $5,600. Chris McAlpine, Gary McCracken, Richard Rooney, I said thank you very much to you. Sony Music Publishing, a $500 gift tonight. And Margaret Atwood, Margaret Atwood says, I am in for $5,000 tonight. Comfort Tech Mechanical, $1,000. You know what? You are going at it. Do not take your foot off the gases. All your feats, your collective feats. We are at $87,100, and this is what I want to do. We have another segment of fundraising coming up, but you know what, kids? Can we get to 150 right now? Scott Ritchie says, oh, yeah, baby Lane. Yeah, Lane, we're in at 1,000. That's what Scott Ritchie says. Thank you very much to Scott. Barbara Nashevich, $100. Thank you so much. Jeanette Gillizzo, $150. And this is what I want to say to you. Of course, we love those large donations, but here is the thing I want to say. $100, $250, $2,500, whatever your number is tonight, I want to say, imagine if everybody online gives tonight. Imagine if everyone makes a donation. Just imagine what we are going to accomplish together. We are sitting at $88,350. Let's get some more names up on the board. Let's get this thing going. Keep it moving along, kids. Look at me. Look into my eyes with your eyes. I am telling you right now, Peter Van De Heuvel, $100. That's what I'm telling you right now. Petey Baby, thank you very much for coming in and giving your donation tonight. Of course, every donation that is made tonight will receive a charitable tax receipt. And we are sitting at $88,450. My friends, we are kissing $100,000. Chris Latandres, $50. Thank you so much. Adrian Lang, baby. Adrian Baby came in at $500 gift right now. I thank everyone that has given a donation. But you know what? For those folks that haven't, I'm talking to you right now. We need you. We need your names on the board. We need numbers on the board. I am telling you, Sean Humphrey, just said, Lane, I'm in for $350. We are sitting at $89,250. My friends, work with me right now. Let's get some hero and shiro power building in your living rooms, in your family rooms. Maybe you're watching with your friends. You know what? Challenge each other. If you're having a dinner party, challenge each other and say, you know what? Everyone in my house, boom, $500 on the credit card. That's what we're going to do, because you know what? We are going to change lives tonight. We are at 89,250. My producer is looking at me, giving me the sign to wind it down. But can we get to 100,000 in one more minute? I am looking for 10 people to give $1,000 right now. We're sitting at 89,250. And you know what? We have done extremely well. Our goal is $150,000. I am going to be back. We are going to do this again. And everyone who hasn't had an opportunity to donate, I am going to be calling on you. And folks, if you already have made a donation, I'm going to be calling on you again. Maybe you're going to be what I call a double dipper donor tonight. All right. Thank you so much. I'm going to be back shortly. I need to have a little bit of a break, but right now I'm going to throw it back to Sangita Patel.
Amazing energy. Thank you, Lane. And a big thanks to all of you who dialed up those phones to support this incredible work. I can see your halo from here. We'll be back with one more Fundanee moment later in the evening, so don't put those phones away just yet. And don't forget to purchase your golden ticket before end of the show. Air Canada has generously donated 2 business class tickets to anywhere Air Canada flies. That's a $30,000 value. And we've got a limited number of tickets for only $100 each. So go to warchild.ca/gala to purchase yours now. Ticket purchase will close in 5 minutes. Lane will be drawing the winner shortly, so be sure to get your tickets and start planning an amazing adventure now that we can travel again. I'm now thrilled to introduce a very special talent. Juno-nominated singer-songwriter Amaal knows what it means to flee war. Born in Somalia, Amaal was a child when her family fled to Canada, where she has thrived. We are delighted to have her here with us tonight. Take it over.
Days I would visit, you did your
That was simply gorgeous. Thank you so much, Amaal. Now let's take a moment to hear from War Child's overseas staff. Did you know that War Child staff around the world are 99% local to the areas they serve? This means that they understand the cultural context and the needs of their communities and are perfectly positioned to reach those that are hardest hit by war and conflict. A few of these staff members join us now to tell us what sets War Child apart.
We shake up outdated concepts of charity and humanitarian aid to break the cycles of poverty and violence.
We are recognized as global leaders in designing and delivering programs that support children and families affected by war.
Our programs do more than respond to critical needs. They empower communities and foster resilience, self-reliance, and self-determination.
Our collaborative mode of humanitarian action is 100% locally driven and locally led.
At War Child, we think long term. Our programs are sustainable and their impacts are felt over generations. Thank you for supporting War Child and our staff overseas so that they can continue this important work.
You know, I don't know why, but everything about you seems comfortable to me. Feel like I'm the one, feel like I'm your only one, and everything else seems small. Babe, I don't know why, but everything about you is a realist to me. Feel like I'm your man, feel like I'm the only man, and we can get through it all. But I don't wanna need you, I don't wanna leave you. I just wanna see you, feel you, and be real, yeah. I just don't know how to love you, just don't know how to be committed to you, baby, so effortlessly. I don't know how to love you the way you need to be, 'cause I've been around and I've been run down, yeah. I need therapy, 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 therapy. Sometimes I'm alone late night, thinking about the mess I got inside. Ruin the illusion of your paradise, saying I won't change my mind. But I don't wanna lead you on, I might wanna be the one. I just wanna see you, feel you, and be real, yeah. I just don't know how to love you, just don't know how to be committed to you, baby, so effortlessly. Don't know how to love you the way you need to be, 'cause I've been around and I've been run down, yeah. I need therapy, therapy, therapy. I need therapy, therapy, therapy. Maybe all I need is a pill or two, a sit-down conversation, a new attitude. But if there's a possibility of losing you, I'll do what I need, what I need. Oh, therapy.
Absolutely beautiful. Thank you to Gary Slate music artist Theo Tams for that performance. So good. I hope that everyone is enjoying themselves and has had the time to bid on the amazing silent auction items online at warchild.ca/gala. The auction will close at 3 p.m. tomorrow. I'm hoping to win the meet and greet with Troy and Bellisario and the foursome at the Angus Glen golf club. That would be so much fun. We've got more to look forward to this evening, including a special musical performance by Canadian icons Blue Rodeo, War Child Ambassador Chantal Kreviazuk, and the lovely and talented JP Saxe. And Lane the Auctionista will also join us once again to help us blow past the fundraising target. So get your phones ready. To help set the mood with a moving and thought-provoking spoken word performance, I am pleased to welcome a man whose words have inspired others to follow his voice, his journey, and his advocacy, poet and public speaker Wali Shah.
Suffering will never end. You're foolish if you believe that we can be the reason things will change. Humanity strives for a better world. Is nothing but delusion. People only care about themselves. Countries like Afghanistan are a lost cause. Only the ignorant feel education will make a difference. We have no power. So stop preaching that each of us can save a life. COVID reminds us that our families have never had to struggle. It can't possibly be that we can empathize with those less fortunate. In the face of war and famine, there is absolutely nothing you can do. Do you really think change starts with you? But now let's read this in reverse with a new point of view. Change starts with you. Do you really think there is absolutely nothing you can do? In the face of war and famine, we can empathize with those less fortunate. It can't possibly be that our families have never had to struggle. COVID reminds us that each of us can save a life. So stop preaching that we have no power. Education will make a difference. Only the ignorant feel countries like Afghanistan are a lost cause. People only care about themselves is nothing but delusion. Humanity strives for a better world. We can be the reason things will change. You're foolish if you believe that suffering will never end. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Wali. That was absolutely breathtaking. Some of you may be wondering what War Child hopes to accomplish by remaining in Afghanistan. And so tonight we want to show you not only what we're doing, but what we hope to be able to continue doing with your support. We have already begun our work in the area of emergency education with a focus on women and girls to ensure that they have access to the high quality education that they both need and deserve. We also continue to work in the area of basic needs, providing food security for some of the most desperate families, particularly the many hundreds of thousands of people who have been displaced as a result of the recent violence. We also will continue to fight for the rights of women and children, sometimes against extraordinary odds, but we have seen firsthand the tremendous impact of those efforts. Tonight, I invite you to learn a little bit more about what it is that we have been doing in the country and what we hope to do with your support. Thank you so much.
Over the past two decades, War Child's programs have helped change the lives of more than 1.5 million women and children in Afghanistan. We are recognized leaders in developing programs that protect and empower the most vulnerable groups living in the most complex humanitarian environments.
Our work in Afghanistan has achieved unprecedented success thanks to our 99% local staff,
strong community networks, and collaborative approach to humanitarian action.
With your support tonight, we can continue to
strengthen education for women and girls, provide emergency education and child protection services to at-risk children who have been displaced by violence, promote food and economic security for families living in extreme poverty, advance women's and children's rights and defend victims of human rights violations. Together, we can create new opportunities for Afghan women and children to build brighter futures for themselves and their communities.
We need your help to continue our work. Please give generously.
What an incredible evening we're having so far, and I'm sure you feel like I do. You know, I am so moved by the art, by the stories. And, you know, I've got to tell you, folks, we are here to show up for War Child. And, you know, even though tonight, you know, there are social occasions happening, what we really need to focus on right in this moment right now is why we are here. Tonight is a signature fundraising occasion for War Child. And we have a job to do. We have a serious job to do. We have a fundraising goal of raising $150,000 in donations. We have done this before. We did it last year. And now I am asking each and every one of you to show up for War Child and make a donation. It's as simple as going to the donation tab and picking one of the pre-selected donation amounts, or make a donation of any size, any amount. Maybe your favorite number is 777, and that is what you're going to give tonight. My friends, we are sitting at 89.9. We have to get to $150,000 before the end of the show. And as I said earlier, this is on all of us. This is on a community. This is about pooling our resources, you know, $100, $1,000, $25,000. And actually, while I was off screen, I do want to say thank you to these following folks for their gifts this evening. Joanne Doretta and Cole Lawyer of CI Private Wealth, thank you so much for your $1,000 gift. Charmaine Cortes and David Dimmick, they gave $500 to our fundraising tonight. Charlene Cortes, $1,000. Sarah and Scott Patterson, a $15,000 gift. And here's what I'm saying to you, my friends. We have a $500 gift, $1,000, $15,000. They are all incredibly important. They are all critical. They are all crucial. And they will all come together to help us achieve our goal tonight. You know, failure is not an option. We still have three or four more minutes to go with me, and I want to work with you. I want to inspire you. And, you know, you heard Sam earlier on this evening. Think about the work that War Child is doing, and think about the work that has to be done. None of this is possible without your help. So now I am asking you. I'm asking you to get ready. I am asking you to make that donation, and I'm asking you, oh yeah, you know what? I am not too shy to ask you to double dip tonight, and that means maybe you gave once, and now you're ready to give again. So, my friends, are you locked, loaded, baby, and ready to go? Let's go. We're at 99,925, 104,000. The Ghani Foundation just gave $5,000. Anna Ghani is a War Child Canada board member. Thank you. Pallier, Roland, Rosenberg, Rothstein, LLP, $20,000. I can't believe it. Here we go. Susan Greer, you're in at $1,000. It is happening, and I am not stopping. I'm not leaving this place until we get over $150,000. We're at $129,125. Who else do we have out there? I need somebody else. Sean and Robin Fahey. $3,200. Keep those names coming. Keep those beautiful names coming. I want to see $50 gifts. How about a $250 gift? How about a $1,000 gift tonight? Tonight is the night. Tonight is December the 7th. We are edging close to the end of 2021, and War Child needs you. War Child needs to step into 2022. With $150,000 in donations, my friends, we are sitting at $129,125. That means we have $20,000 more to go. So now I'm going to get really serious. Now I am looking for $20,000. Could there be 10 people out there that would like to give a $2,000 gift? Maybe there are 20 people that say, you know what, tonight is my night. I'm coming in strong. I'm coming in fierce. I'm going to stand behind War Child tonight, and I am going to make another gift. Kristen McLeod, thank you very much for $150. Chris McAlpine, thank you very much for a $5. $500 gift. We need to get some more names. Gwendolyn Carter, $50. I love that. Thank you so much. Let's get that moving. Let's move that along. My friends, we are so close. We are so close. The producer is looking at me and I'm not looking into his eyes. Absolutely not. I am looking at you. Nobody exists. You know what? All that exists is all of you and me. And Leslie Waddell is listening to me. Leslie, baby, $100 from Leslie. Leslie says, yes, let's inch that number forward. Let's get that number up to $150,000. And of course, the Ghani Foundation, $5,000. I said, thank you already, but I need to see some more names. My friends, I know that there is so much capacity out there. You think I can't see you? Oh, I can see you. I can see you, and you know what? I can feel you. So don't look away. Now is not the time to take your dog out. Now is not the time to open up another bottle of wine. Now is the time to focus. Now is the time to look around the room that you are sitting in. Look to your spouse. Look to your daughter. Look to your son. Look to your colleagues and say, we're going after this. And Sue Gerard said, yeah, Lainey, baby, bring me in at $500. And we are so close. My friends, challenge each other. Challenge each other. Do the right thing tonight. There is a reason why you are tuned in. There is a reason why you continue to stand behind War Child. Karen Wildgoose said, I am standing behind War Child with a $100 gift tonight. My friends, we are sitting at just under, there we go, we're over $130,000, but the producer is now has a squirt bottle right at my face saying, Lane, we love you, but now it's time to move on. But I've got more to say about this. So Dara McLeod, thank you very much for $500. Shelly Ambrose, $500. See, I know that you hear me. I know that you're with me. And I know that you are here because you are committed to the work that War Child does. All right. Vicky Resednick, $50. Okay, I could go on forever, but I've got to move on. I have got to move on. All right. While I was off screen, I was also looking at the silent auction. And I'm going to tell you, you kids, you got a little competitive edge in there, don't you? Now, that silent auction is bumping. And of course, the silent auction is going to close tomorrow at 3 p.m. Eastern time. So keep your eyes on your fries. I mean, your prize. Don't let that air fryer slip through your fingers, all right? Don't let that happen. All right. Kids, it's golden ticket time. All right. Thank you all so much. All of you who purchased golden tickets, they were $100 each. And of course, the prize is it's outrageous. It is a $30,000 value. And of course, it's been donated by Air Canada. This is a round trip for two, business class, anywhere that Air Canada flies, and it is stacked. I mean, it is loaded with prestige services, and you are going to be mind blown when you travel with Air Canada. And we have a winner. We have a winner. And the winner is Jeffrey Orridge. Jeffrey Orridge, Jeffrey Orridge, you are gonna travel, baby. You're gonna travel in style, Jeffrey. And guess what? I'm available most of next July. So, hey, I'm an amazing travel partner. I will keep you laughing. I will keep you hydrated. And we could have a really good time. All right, my friends. I have Barbara Harmer standing beside me 2 inches away saying, Lane, we just received another major donation, and I am here to say the one and only Gary Slate, $5,000. Gary, we love you, and thank you very much. You are a hero tonight, and you have pushed our total up well into the $134,000 range. All right, Jeffrey Orridge, just a little bit of reminder for realsies. War Child is going to call you tomorrow to arrange drop-off of the Boeing 747 so that you can start making your travel plans. All right, friends, we have accomplished something absolutely amazing together. Our fundraising total right now is sitting at $136,625. My dear friends, my dear supporters, I want to say we thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Every gift has made a difference. Every donation has added up to $136,625. We are that close. And you know what? We are going to keep the fundraising site open until, when did we say? Friday at 6 p.m. This Friday, December 10th at 6 p.m. Because here is what I want you to do. This is my last call to action for you, my friends. I would like you to share this event with your family, your friends, your colleagues, and your special circles. And you tell them why you're here tonight. You tell them why you support War Child and why the work is so critical. And then I want you to ask them and say, I need you to make a donation. And I have no doubt in my mind, my friends, that by the end of Day Friday, we will achieve and exceed $150,000 in donations. You are wonderful. We thank you all so much. I really don't want to go, but I have to go now. My name is Lane the Auctionista. I cannot wait to see you next year. And now, back to Sangita Patel.
What amazing support from Air Canada. What a prize. Hey, if you need a plus one, I mean, I'm ready to go anytime. I'll pack my bags. Let's go. Thank you, everyone. Wow, what amazing energy and generosity. Keep those donations coming in all night. Just keep going. Keep going. It is now my honor to welcome the fabulously talented and one and only Blue Rodeo. These guys are truly amazing. Blue Rodeo have sold over 4 million albums and are still going strong. I can't wait to hear their latest album, Many a Mile. Blue Rodeo have won dozens of awards, including the Governor General's Performing Arts Award and the Order of Canada. They've played thousands of shows across the country, and tonight they are here just to play for you. Over to you, Jim.
Hi, I'm Jim Cuddy from Blue Rodeo, and we are very, very, very honored to be part of this evening celebrating and helping War Child. War Child goes to a lot of places that we all, as citizens of the world, should be aware of, but tragically are often not aware of. And they bring them to our attention, and they do a lot to help people, and they push through barriers. And so we're just very thrilled to be able to add even our tiny little bit to this. So enjoy.
I want to know where my confidence went. One day it all disappeared. I'm lying in a hotel room miles away. Voices next door in my ear. Daytimes are dry, nighttimes are worse. Hope that I can get home soon. fire. People laugh while it burns. Well, I tried to run, but my legs were numb. I had to wait till the feeling returned. Well, I don't need a doctor to figure it out. I know what's passing me by. When I look in the mirror, sometimes I see traces of some other guy. I wanna go, no, I can't stay, but I don't wanna run, feeling this way. Till I am myself. Till I am myself. Till I am myself again.
Thank you very much.
Our next guest is a Grammy-nominated singer-songwriter who joins us from the road. J.P. Saxe is supporting War Child while on his Dangerous Levels of Introspection tour. And we are so thrilled to have him with us to play his Grammy-nominated hit, If the World Was Ending.
I was distracted and in traffic. I couldn't feel it when the earthquake happened, but it really got me thinking, were you out drinking? Were you in the living room chilling, watching television? It's been in, I think I figured out how to let you go and let communication die. I know, you know, you know, you weren't down for forever and it's fine. I know, we weren't meant for each other and it's fine. But if the world was ending, you'd come over, right? You'd come over and you'd stay the night. Would you love me for the hell of it? All our fears would be irrelevant. If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? Sky be falling while I hold you tight. Oh, there wouldn't be a reason why we would even have to say goodbye. If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? Right? If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? I tried to imagine your reaction. Didn't scare me when the earthquake happened, but it really got me thinking. That night we went drinking, stumbled in the house and didn't make it past the kitchen. Oh, it's been here now. I think I've figured out how to think about you without it ripping my heart out. And I know, you know, we know, you weren't down for forever and it's fine. I know, you know, we weren't meant for each other and it's fine. But if the world was ending, you'd come over, right? You'd come over and you'd stay the night. Would you love me for the hell of it? All our fears would be irrelevant. If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? Sky be falling while I hold you tight. No, there wouldn't be a reason why we would even have to say goodbye. If the world was ending, you'd come over, right? You'd come over, you'd come over, you'd come over, right? If the world was ending, you'd come over, right?
Good evening, everyone. Hi, I'm Chantal Kreviazuk, War Child's biggest fan. And supporter, you know, anything I can do for War Child, because their programs speak for themselves. I'm proud to be an advocate for War Child, a witness to what Dr. Sam Nutt and her amazing team do every day. And it's important work. And really, I just cannot thank you all enough for being here with me from my home studio in Los Angeles tonight. And I would like to sing you a song that, while I didn't write this song, but people seem to know it as a song that is signature to me in my career now. I'm really proud of it. It's a Randy Newman song. And honestly, it's meaningful to me now because I've learned that even in the science of the brain, a person's home, that's their sanctuary. And I have been in regions with Sam and local partners in the War Child team. And I have bared witness to people whose home is no longer their own, people in IDP camps whose home is not even that far away, but it is inaccessible to them. Man, I don't know how they do it. I would be going crazy. And I meet the most amazing people who are dignified and hopeful. And tonight, I really just want to be able to share that inspiration with you, and I want to be able to support people in their efforts to get home. All right, and I am at home, and I have dogs, and I have children, so bear with me, but we'll get through it. I hope you have a wonderful time in your home this evening. This is Feels Like Home.
There's something in your eyes makes me want to lose myself. Makes me want to lose myself in your arms. There's something in your voice makes my heart beat fast. Hope this feeling lasts the rest of my life. If you knew how lonely my life has been, or how long I felt so alone. To come along and change my life the way you've done. Well, it feels like home to me. Feels like home to me. Feels like I'm all the way back where I come from. Feels like home to me. Feels
I'd love anyone so much. And well, it feels like home to me. Feels like home to me. Feels like I'm all the way back where I come from.
Thank you, Chantal. That was just amazing. You are such an incredible ambassador for the cause, and we are so grateful for your ongoing support. I also want to thank the terrific talent, the outstanding performers who made tonight's virtual event possible. Thank you for coming out for us again this year and for helping to raise such a tremendous amount of money. We are so indebted to all of you. I especially want to thank each and every single one of you who tuned in this evening, our dedicated donors, and our sponsors. We work with 500,000 children throughout the world every year. Because of your investment, because of your belief in us, that work is possible. Thank you for coming out for us again. Next year though, next year, fingers crossed, we will be able to get together in person. That's, I know, what we all hope for. I want to wish you a very happy and healthy holiday season. And thank you again for everything that you have done for us and for the children that we serve throughout the world. With that, I want to pass it back to the incredible Sangita. This is her fourth year hosting our event. Every year, it just gets better and better. Thank you so much, Sangita, for all that you do, and back to you.
Thank you, Sam. It's been such a pleasure to be your host this evening. What an incredible night. I know that the funds raised tonight will do so much good for vulnerable children at this critical time, and I feel very proud by what we have accomplished together this evening. Don't forget that you can still donate and bid on the silent auction items. The silent auction closes at 3 p.m. Eastern tomorrow, December 8th. You have been such wonderful supporters tonight. Thank you for your big hearts and especially your big wallets. You are a part of a global community of extraordinary people using your powers for good. Thank you.